Hello everyone, I welcome you once again. Today we will discuss sexual reproduction in bacteria. There are different methods of sexual reproduction in bacteria, namely transformation, conjugation, transduction. But in this particular this video, we will only discuss conjugation. Here you can see there are two bacteria, 1 and 2, which are actually joining with this conjugation tube. So let's start it. Here there are two bacteria. Number one is this, number two is this, and these two bacteria, they are connected by this, you can say that conjugation tube, and it is also known as mating bridge. Mating bridge, it is also known by the name conjugation tube, and these bacteria, they are actually involved in the transferring of genetic material. Therefore, the genetic recombination will take place, which is known as genetic recombination. It is important as far as the sexual reproduction of bacterium is concerned. आप मेरे बारे में यहाँ से जान सकते हैं. Myself विनय कुमार and currently I am working as an assistant professor of botany in Government College Panchkula, Haryana. First of all, we should clear about genetic recombination. What do you mean by genetic recombination? Simple है. The genes from two different organisms or cells, they recombine. If they recombine, then new genes recombination are formed. New genes recombination are formed, and we can say that genetic recombination is occurring. And if genetic recombination is occurring, the sexual reproduction is occurring, and this is known as genetic recombination. In case of bacteria, there is primitive type of sexual reproduction. What do you mean by primitive type of sexual reproduction? We can also call it as parasexuality. What do you mean by parasexuality? In this case, there is no gamete formation, no gametangia formation. You can say that no sexual apparatus is formed, no fusion of gametes is there, and no full-fledged zygote is formed, and there is no meiotic division. Meiotic division is absent. Agar ye sari cheezein absent hain, if there is no meiosis, there is no full-fledged zygote is formed, and there is no gamete formation, there is no fusion of gametes, we can call it as primitive type of sexual reproduction or parasexuality or genetic recombination in case of bacteria. As we have already discussed, there are three methods of genetic recombination in case of bacteria, or we can say that three methods of sexual reproduction in bacteria, namely transformation, conjugation and transduction. Only conjugation is taken up here. What do you mean by conjugation? We have already discussed. And what are the features? वो हम देख लेते हैं. It was first of all given by Lederberg and Tatum in 1946 in bacteria, which is known as E. coli. और E. coli में the cell-to-cell union occurs with the help of conjugation tube, which we have already discussed. The genetic material of one bacterial cell, it goes into the another cell lengthwise. ये बहुत important चीज़ है. ये lengthwise जो हमने बोला है, the lengthwise we can say that it is horizontal gene transfer. Horizontal gene transfer का मतलब है कि same generation के cells के बीच में horizontal gene transfer हो रहा है. एक होता है वर्टिकल जीन ट्रांसफर. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय वर्टिकल जीन ट्रांसफर? द पेरेंट्स, दे आर एक्चुअली ट्रांसफरिंग द जीन्स टू देयर डॉटर सेल्स. हियर देयर आर नो डॉटर सेल्स. हियर द सेल्स आर ऑफ सेम जनरेशन, सेम एज, एंड स्टिल there is genetic recombination. Still, there is the transference of a genetic material from one cell to another, which is known as horizontal gene transfer. इससे रिलेटेड हम क्वेश्चन भी करेंगे बाद में, तब ज्यादा क्लियर हो जाएगा कि व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय हॉरिजॉन्टल जीन ट्रांसफर एंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय वर्टिकल जीन ट्रांसफर. द जीन ट्रांसफर इट इज एक्चुअली बिटवीन वन डोनर सेल एंड वन रिसिपिएंट सेल. द डोनर विच इज गिविंग द जीन एंड रिसिपिएंट सेल विच इज एक्सेप्टिंग द जीन. एंड donor cell, it is always having the F factor. F factor, it is also known as F plasmid. It is also known as a fertility plasmid. And the cell which is having the F plasmid, it is capable of forming the sex pili, which is also known as pilus singly or pili plural, sex pili. And this sex pili, when it fuses with the recipient cell, it can form the continuous conjugation tube. So for a donor cell, it is must having F factor, and for a recipient cell, the F factor is absent. Here we can say that here the first type of conjugation is there. First type of conjugation is sterile male method. In this case, we shall remember that in the end of this mating, which is F positive into F negative, means there is a mating between F positive bacteria and F negative bacteria, and at the end of this mating process, the F negative bacteria, it is getting converted into F positive bacteria. This means the this bacteria, which is not having the F factor initially, it will have the F factor ultimately, and again this bacteria will now form the sex pili, and this bacteria can now form the very method of conjugation. So let's start it. Here are the two cells. First cell is F positive cell, this one, and second cell is F negative cell. Why it is F positive? Because it is having the F plasmid, and if it is having the F plasmid, it can form the sex pili, which after fusion with this very cell, it can make the this mating bridge, which is also known as conjugation tube. And in second step, you can see that this F plasmid, it is actually having two strands of DNA. Two strands of DNA. These two strands of DNA, out of which one strand split itself and then start transferring into the F negative cell. In third case, in third step, you can see that this single strand and this single strand, they can form their own complementary strand. So hoga kya? At the end of this process, both these single stranded F plasmid, they are now double stranded, and therefore the F negative cell, therefore the F negative cell is now converting into F positive cell, and therefore you can say that this ultimate F positive cell, which is resulted due to this F positive into F negative mating, can is now capable of forming the conjugation tube or sex pili. Here is the second type of this conjugation. This is also known as fertile male method. This fertile male method, why it is known as fertile male method, we will discuss it later. To understand this very method, we first have to understand what is the requirement of this step to be fulfilled by this bacteria. We can say that this first cell is F positive cell, and this F positive cell, it is having it is having the F plasmid. But in this case, F plasmid, F, to isko F positive bolenge, obviously. This F plasmid, it is now getting integrated in this bacterial main genome. Why it is getting integrated in this genome? Because some of the genes, they are complementary to each other, and therefore they can recombine with each other. And integration of this F factor into this chromosome, this cell is now known as HFR. This HFR cell, it is now can be regarded as high frequency donor. And due to this formation of high frequency donor, or it is also known as meta male cell, or it is also known as super male. And due to this formation of super male cell in this step, this is also known as fertile male method. तो चलिए आगे शुरू करते हैं कि ये प्रोसेस होगी कैसे. देखिए, this is HFR conjugation. Here you can see that these this area, which is light blue colored area, these are the genes of F factor, and these are already getting integrated into this bacterial main genome, and therefore this cell, it is known as HFR or high frequency donor cell. And in this case, what will happen, you can see here in second step. देखिए इसमें integration के बाद when these genes, they are getting incorporated into this very cell, the whole genome after splitting, they are started to get transferred into this very cell. होगा क्या, जो F plasmid है वो बीच में से, F plasmid के genes बीच में से split कर जाएंगे और transference शुरू हो जाएगी whole genome की into this F negative cell. This F negative cell में जो F plasmid के genes हैं वो already इसमें incorporated हो चुके हैं, but F plasmid के जो genes हैं, they are getting incorporated into this very cell along with the main genome. But ये ultimately जो कुछ ही जीन्स हैं F plasmid के, वही ट्रांसफर हो पाएंगे. रीजन बीइंग बिकॉज द कॉन्जुगेशन, इट इज अ वेरी शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोसेस, वेरी शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोसेस, एंड ड्यू टू द शॉर्टेज ऑफ टाइम दिस होल जीनोम, इट इज नॉट कैपेबल ऑफ ट्रांसफरिंग इटसेल्फ फ्रॉम दिस सेल टू दिस. And therefore, not all the genes of F plasmid are transferred into this F negative cell. And therefore, after some time, this conjugation tube, it is now broken. देखिए यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं, conjugation tube already break हो चुकी है. Only some of the F plasmid genes are getting transferred into this very cell. And therefore, this cell will again remain as F negative cell, and it cannot form the sex pili, and it cannot form the conjugation tube. And some of the integration of gene or recombination gene, recombination of gene may take place here, but ultimately the single stranded DNA, which is transferred into this very cell, it is now broken down by the enzymes, cellular enzymes. यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं, cellular enzymes degrade यानी linear DNA, because linear DNA को कभी भी जो bacterial cell है वो अपने cell में tolerate नहीं करता है. तो this is known as fertile male में. The third one is F prime conjugation. F prime conjugation. What do you mean by this F prime conjugation? We will see that. Dekhi, in this case, this F plasmid, it is already having some of the genes of main genome. Main genome mein already genes kuch ye le chuka hai F plasmid. Ab obviously yahan pe F plasmid to hai hi, तो ये कॉन्जुगेशन ट्यूब तो बना सकता है. ये देखिए कॉन्जुगेशन ट्यूब इसने बना दी है, और एफ नेगेटिव सेल के साथ ये कॉन्जुगेट हो चुका है. ये इन दोनों सेल्स को कॉन्जुगेंट बोलेंगे. और अभी देखिए, ऑलरेडी मेन जीनोम के कुछ जीन्स एफ प्लाज्मिड के पास हैं, When this F plasmid, it is transferred into this F negative bacteria, तो main genome के already genes इसमें transfer हो जाएंगे और main genome इसके पास अपना है, एक copy यहाँ पे main genome के genes की हो गई और दूसरी copy जो F plasmid transfer करेगा, तो दो copies होने की वजह से ये diploid, partially diploid zygote गिना जाएगा, partially diploid zygote, और ये full fledged zygote नहीं है, that's why it is known as merozygote. Further slides में हम ये जरूर देखेंगे कि merozygote क्या होता है, what is the fate of merozygote, merozygote का बाद में क्या होता है, ये further slides में अभी बनाऊंगा, इसमें videos में हम देखेंगे कि what is the fate of merozygote, और we will discuss in third type of जो transduction है, उसका जो video आएगा, उसमें जरूर हम ये discuss करेंगे कि what will be the fate of merozygote after all these sexual reproduction method जो है, वो complete हो जाएंगे, तो merozygote का होगा क्या? तो देखिए यहाँ पे इसका अपना F plasmid है, देखिए इसका अपना F plasmid है और इसने इसमें भी F plasmid को यहाँ पे shift कर दिया है, देखिए already F plasmid में एक copy यहाँ पे main genome की पहले ही थी क्योंकि वो यहाँ से ले ली थी और second copy यहाँ पे आएगी और दो copies होने की वजह से इसको हम partially diploid zygote कह सकते हैं इस cell को and it is now known as merozygote cell. और मेरोज़ाइगोट सेल का फेट क्या है वो हम आने वाले वीडियोस में हम देखेंगे. So if this cell is now F prime because of the presence of this very copy of this main genome, this cell is also known as F prime. So one F prime bacteria, it is now forming this bacteria as F prime. Okay? So in this case, what is happening? F negative bacteria, it is getting converted into F prime bacteria. This is all. So thank you. अभी मिलते हैं अगले लेक्चर में हम.